welcoming the doorman. Awoke to a familiar buzzing coming within the ceiling, the janitress quickly staggered to her feet from laying down in her bed. She stayed silent, hoping that she had just misheard those familiar noises. But as hue of red light glimmered its way under her cell door, she let out a loud sigh before staring quietly at her broom, mop, and other cleaning supplies. "Not again," she muttered to herself as she picked up her trusty tools and headed out her door. Quickly, the stench of concrete dust, large piles of maggot-covered flesh, and dried blood filled her nostrils. It would be unbearable for any normal human to bear witness to such a horrific scene, but for the janitress, it was a monthly routine, one she knew the inevitability of, yet still despised. She sighed once more, pulling out multiple black garbage bags and grabbing the freshly ridden limbs from individuals she once thought were her friends, right outside her cell door. She, however, continued on, not letting it get to her, grabbing stray pieces of the facility wall and tossing them in the bag along with the limbs. Then, she stopped something down the hall, a figure curled up in a ball weeping next to a doorway. The janitress approached the weeping figure she recognized as a D-class. "Hey, you fine?" she questioned the D-class as she bent over in front of it. But she got no reply, only quiet pleading and uncontrollable sobbing. As she peered her head up, she had noticed a wooden door with a small glass window. The janitress took a peek through the glass window to see what was on the other side, possibly more bodies she had to clean, but it quickly noticed something was staring back. A creature, silhouetted by a barely functional hallway ceiling light, inches away from her face, right beyond the glass window of the door, its skin a dried, yellowish color with a texture that appeared similar to leather, and an enlarged jaw that took up the majority of its faceless exterior. The janitress swiftly backed away from the glass, pulling out her assortment of keys in an attempt at unlocking the door. She turned the door's lock and began to fiddle each key into the socket, trying to figure out which key was the correct one. After a few moments, she heard a slight click in the door's lock, meaning it was open. She turned again to view the monstrosity she saw once before, only to find it had vanished, and so had the nearby D-class. Standing there from utter shock, she tried to clear her mind of everything that was happening, but the continuous buzzing of the red emergency lights reminded her of what she needed to do. The janitress reluctantly walked back to her containment cell, maybe to reevaluate her life choices and how she ended up in the position that she was currently. As she arrived to her cell door, she started to open it. Then she felt a small amount of pushback from behind the door before it fully opened, but it gave her a tiny opening to see inside the room. She tilted her head and peered into the tiny space to find a familiar face staring back. Feelings of anxiety coated the janitress as she was met by the presence of this once again formidable and disturbing creature. She continuously stared in awe at the creature's gaping chasm of a mouthful face before muttering to the creature, "You know, I'm sure any dentist would love you as a patient." And she swore that she could see the creature put on a large grin before disappearing behind her cell door. The janitress was then left with a feeling of dread, yet she knew this time, after meeting that creature, it would occur much more often.